Welcome to Health Education Module 3. Your course code is HE30D3. My name is S. Dube and I'm going to be the presenter for this module. First, let's look at the course content. This module is going to look at, among others, the dynamics of HIV, that's an advanced study, the effects of HIV on the immune system and disease progression, HIV and opportunistic infections, study of antiretroviral therapy, monitoring of antiretroviral therapy, adherence in antiretroviral therapy, nutrition and HIV, living positively with HIV, study on the national health policy and the healthcare system in Namibia, post-exposure prophylaxis, PEP. Learning outcomes. The module aims to assist students and increase their understanding of the viral cycle through an advanced study, to help students understand how medicine works on inhibiting the cycle, thus improving the life of the infected individual. We want students to be able to explore the critical aspects of nutrition and its role in successful treatment and managing of side effects. And also we want students to be able to provide the historical conceptual background for the human rights movement, to help students to present an overview of the international and regional legal frameworks in the field of human rights, conversations, covenants, and declarations. To introduce students to the links between HIV/AIDS and human rights, and why human rights are fundamental to any response to HIV and AIDS. Introductory overview. This manual has been designed and written to assist students to increase their understanding of the viral cycle through an advanced study, which also helps them understand how medicine works on inhibiting the cycle and thus improving the life of the infected individual. The unit on opportunistic infection discusses the effects of the virus on the immune system, the relationship between immune system and progression of the disease. The study of antiretroviral focuses particularly on the different classes available in the world, but in particular in Namibia and how it works, and further develop the understanding of the importance of monitoring ARV therapy towards successful outcomes and improved adherence. The critical aspects of nutrition and its role in successful treatment and managing of side effects are discussed. The manual also examines the national policy and post-exposure prophylaxis guidelines in Namibia. Having dealt with different aspects of in terms of HIV and its effect on individuals, students are now beginning to analyze the adherence, the different medical, biomedical situations related to ARDS, opportunistic infections, disease progression, the role of nutrition and adherence in more detail. Students should now beginning to develop working knowledge and skills in HIV studies. Furthermore, students are encouraged to continuously consult libraries and the internet in their quest to gather recent information on HIV and AIDS. You can look at issues, for example, the 1990 concept, which is under Vision 2020, and also the concept of PrEP. PrEP means post, then PrEP means pre. It has recently been introduced in Namibia, and you need to continuously update yourself about that. This manual contains the most current information, yet it is important to remember that HIV and AIDS and its treatments are an ongoing matter and are being researched. Hence, you need to stay ahead of the game. One thing which is very important as an HIV/AIDS student is to understand the structure of the human immunodeficiency virus. And I cannot stress enough that whole component. You need to understand how the virus enters the body. Next, how this virus attaches itself to the CD4 cells, which are the most critical cells. How it changes itself from the RNA to the DNA. How it goes to the core of the CD4 cells and makes copies of itself. and how it comes, cuts itself out and move out. And also in the same vein, how this may, because you must remember that the progression of the virus right until it makes itself is the same route through which treatment works. So if you understand how the virus enters the body, changes itself, and how the medication stops that process from taking place, and also how the medication works in stopping the whole process of, you actually become a very good HIV AIDS manager, because this structure of HIV, of the CD4 cell, plays a very important role. Okay. Let's look at assignments. You are required to do assignments, and your assignment one is basically has got two parts. Assignment one has got two questions. So first of all, describe the HIV cycle in full, from the attachment of the host cell to the maturation of the virus. Use your own ways to show the understanding. And that assignment carries 10 marks. So like I said before, the way HIV interacts with the CD4 cell is very, very fundamental. And that's what helps us as managers of HIV understand in broad detail what the damage which HIV does once it enters the body. Assignment two, draw a schematic of the HIV virus and the host cell, the CD4 cell. So you must draw two diagrams here. One of the HIV virus and one of the host, which is the CD4 cell, to highlight the cycle you described in question one. How would you explain the cycle of the virus to an individual with no medical background? Because when most of the time we tell people HIV kills, HIV does what? But what is lacking mostly is the knowledge around what exactly happens in the body the moment or the minute HIV enters the human body. And this is very fundamental. Assignment two also has got two parts. Discuss the goal of ARV therapy. There are four goals of ARVs, and the benefits of HIV and the benefits for HIV infected individuals, their families, and the community at large. So you must visit those four goals of ARV therapy and what benefits does ARV treatment bring to the individual, to the families, and community at large. And that part carries 10 marks. And question two, starting ART is a lifelong commitment. Discuss the side effects associated with the medication. And in each case, explain how you would assist or advise a client to cope with it. Be sure to include in your discussion the issues related to adherence and nutrition. So most of these things are very practical. You can actually visit some of your local clinics, your ARV clinics or CDC clinics, and sit down with a doctor, a pharmacist, or a nurse to take you through the process, to really have a good background about where you are coming from with this. Assignment three is also two parts, right? Discuss the relationship between the CD4 count, the viral load, and opportunistic infection. So there's a relationship between your CD4 count, your viral load, and the opportunistic infection. So we want to understand, we want you to discuss, to describe what is this relationship. And question two, HIV and TB is a lethal combination. Discuss. It has been said that all of us, we've got a TB bacteria inside of us, but in most cases, we are not, we may not suffer from TB, but the minute HIV enters, this bacteria becomes very active. So we want you to look at that in more detail. So what is the relationship there? Discuss. So what it means is, perhaps this is also a very practical assignment. It will require you to visit the TB clinic ask them questions, ask the nurses, make appointments to say, I tell them I'm studying HIV and AIDS. I would like to understand what is the relationship between these things. And you get some very good feedback, because HIV is a very practical subject. You need to have information. Assignment 4, conduct a review of the antenatal survey for report for 20. So the 2017 antenatal survey is coming out very soon. Outline and analyze all the key findings and recommendations in the report. Your analysis should include your own view of the key issues. So if you, the antenatal survey plays a very important role, because this is the survey that tells us how much HIV is in the country, at what rate is HIV being spread. So hence we need to have a good understanding. So this report is very, very important. So perhaps in order for you to really get a good understanding, first and foremost, read all the previous reports until you get hold of the current one. And then from there, you can write a good piece of work. Assignment 5, conduct a review and analysis of the National Health Policy of the Ministry of Health and Social Services. Discuss the current management structures in relationship to the policy and challenges of implementation. So we need, as HIV students, one thing for sure is that we need to read extensively. We need to have our hands full by consulting all these relevant documents to make sure that we have, first and foremost, a clear understanding what it is that we are talking about. Assignment 6, living positively with HIV is a phrase commonly used when referring to self-management for people living with HIV. Elaborate. So we want you to understand the bigger and the broader concept. What does living positively mean? What are the day-to-day engagements that you have to deal with psychologically, emotionally, behaviorally? So you need to look at a deeper level of literature of what does positive living mean. And again, like I said, as an HIV student, you need to visit the library, ask your librarian to really help you to teach you how to search for information on the internet. And from there, you can get lots of document, because you need to read critically. You need to consult several literature to ensure that, or to enable you that you can be where you are supposed to be. Assignment 7. Adherence to ARV is vital to the success of therapy for individuals as well as at community level. Conduct a small study on adherence at three different sites in the city of Windhoek, full and part-time students. As a distance students, you can do it at one of your convenient sites. Okay, if you are say in Kavango region, don't need to come to Windhoek. There are a lot of ARV sites. You can actually go to the hospitals and ask for permission from the superintendent to allow you to do so. For all students, include in your study the challenges and recommendations and compare it to other studies in Africa. So we are looking at the ARV therapy. What are those things that are happening? What is the successes? What are the challenges, etc., etc.? Because you must remember that as much as medication works, there are challenges that are associated with the virus and also with the medication. So what are those challenges? We want you to get to that. And finally, assignment 8. Remember, this is it's a year module, and you need to do 4 assignments for your first semester and another 4 assignments for your second semester. Right, so assignment 8 talks about nutrition. Adequate nutrition for people living with HIV is extremely important. Discuss. So in other words, consult, there is a nutritional guide for people living with HIV. access that document and make sure that you read it in conjunction with your manuals, but also consult other literature also. You have been introduced to research methods, and research methods challenges you to really embark on using the concept of literature review in presenting your work. So, in conclusion, students are strongly encouraged to read widely before attempting the assignments. What does it mean? Consult as much literature as possible before you start writing your assignments. And make sure that you reference your work accordingly using the APA reference guide. Currently, we are using the APA version 6. You can download it from the internet. Make a copy for yourself so that you can follow all the details, because failure to reference your work properly can lead you into the plagiarism trap. And obviously, my contact details are readily available in all your tutorials. You can contact me at any time of your convenience. And all I can say is happy journey ahead. Enjoy your studies.